Now we're going to change gears and talk about grocery shopping. You know when you're going up and down the aisles with your cart and the phrase, what you don't know might hurt you? Well, this definitely applies to shopping. And we have a lot of tips on how to shop for the healthiest food and stay healthy while you do it. And joining us is Shop Smarts Magazine Senior Project Editor Mandy Walker. Welcome this morning,
Mandy.
How are
you? Good to see you. I'm well.
So I had no idea that shopping involves strategy, that where you start is important.
Yeah, there's only so much you can control as far as your food is concerned and safety is concerned, but there are some things you can do if you shop smarter.
And so if you start in the middle of the store, that's important?
Yep. You want to shop for things that don't need to be refrigerated first. So you want to start in the middle of the store, get your cereals, the canned goods, and then produce, and then maybe bulk foods, and then start to think about things like meat and poultry.
You mean
fish,
running around like a headless
foods.
Chicken, which is my strategy, is not the best way to do it.
You have to know your store.
Yeah. And what about, like, meatballs are a staple in my household. Mm. How do you know which ground beef? I stand there and scratch my head.
Yeah, you want to check the date. The sell-by date, so you know about when you should be picking it up. Some packages can be treated with carbon monoxide to make the meat look redder, look fresher,
so
longer.
So you can't judge the meat by its color.
You can't judge it by its color. You want to check the date and then use it within a day or so or freeze it.
Right. And just because it looks fresh, it doesn't necessarily.
It doesn't necessarily mean it doesn't have some bacteria.
And what about handling? There's a lot of ooing going on, you know, when you look at it.
Yeah, one thing you want to avoid are packages that are leaking meat juices or poultry or fish. So you want to take a plastic bag. Sorry, we're going to talk about using more plastic, unfortunately.
Right.
But just to make sure you don't spread any juices that might contain bacteria. You don't want to cross-contaminate anything in your cart. Cover it up with a bag. A lot of bags are near the produce, I mean, in the poultry and
right.
meat now. And use them and keep them in a separate place in your cart.
And you could even puncture the plastic as you're throwing it in the cart.
Yes, you want to be very careful how you treat it.
Right,
treat it
exactly.
as if it's contaminated because it could be.
Now, in our household, we only have hormone-free, antibiotic-free. Is that a big deal?
Yeah, you want to look for, you may want to look for no RBGH or no hormones added. It's a synthetic hormone that's given some cows to increase milk production, but it also causes lameness and udder infections. There's no definitive studies yet on how it affects humans, but if you want to avoid it, look for that.
Definitely better safe than sorry. Now, we don't put plastic in the dishwasher. We don't, you know, put it in the microwave, but how do you know the plastic's safe?
You want to avoid BPA plastic, so you want to look at the recycling codes. Look for a 1, 2, or 5.
Mm.
A 7 code might contain BPA or one that's marked with a PC.
Mm-hmm. And how seriously do you take sell by, eat by dates? Because I'm always like,
it's confusing.
You know, smelling it as if I know what I'm doing and I don't.
And sometimes the off odors can't even indicate whether or not there's bacteria in it. You want to use buy things by the sell by date and certainly use them before the expiration date.
And how can you push it? Do you know if there's a sell by date, do you have to freeze it by a certain time?
Yeah, it depends on the item. Like deli meats, generally, you want to use between 3 and 5 days. Milk can usually go for 7. Anything like meat or poultry or seafood usually is within a day or so or freeze.
Okay, good to know. And these are items that you use because the cart itself might pose a risk.
There have been some studies that show that the cart handles and the cart seats might contain more bacteria than some restrooms
or escalators.
Yeah. So you want to take the wipe that you might find at the beginning or bring your own, and you can just wipe off the handle and the seat, or they do, if you have kids, they do have seat covers that you can buy that are about $20, $30.
I've seen those. I've always thought that those were like a little bit paranoid, but now you're telling me that's a good idea.
Yeah, there can be things on the handle and the seat that you just don't want to spread. You don't want to cross-contaminate all the good stuff you're buying at the store.
Oh, my goodness. Well, all sorts of great tips. Mandy Walker, as always, thanks for joining us.
Sure,
appreciate it. We're going to shop more smart now.